My name is Pedro Salgueiro. I'm responsible for one of the business units of TIMUI that is called Mobile Payments. TIMUI is a company that does mobile marketing, mobile entertainment and mobile payments for more than 10 years now. Started in Portugal, then rapidly expanded to Latin America, Africa, Middle East, CIS and Russia. So, in fact, we are much specialized in what is called the emerging markets. What I came here to talk about in Mobile Games Forum was strategies for monetization and payments through mobile operator billing, and not only mobile operator billing, but also other payment options in emerging markets. It's a payment method that is very common and still pretty good throughout those regions. The conversions are much more higher than using, example, credit cards or others. And not only it's important for companies that are based in Europe or, example, in China or Korea to understand that there are several payment options throughout the world. We started with mobile operator billing because we leverage on the connectivity and the connections that are direct from TIMUI side. But then we saw that our merchants and our partners were requiring a little bit more. Things like credit card payments. And when you think about credit card payments, you also have to think about how to process the local credit cards, not the international ones. Then you look at local payment options, like Boleto Bancário in Brazil. People also must know that that is one option. And like bank transfer. So that's what the presentation was a bit about. I'll give you a very good example. If you go to developed markets and you talk about premium SMS, people will say, premium SMS, what is that? We are talking about direct carrier billing, all of that. But when you go to the emerging markets, premium SMS still is a good way to make payments. And so, in fact, the language, the technology, the way you approach people are completely different. Sometimes, even you have to explain to people that are in developed markets, that want to go to emerging markets, how things work and why carrier billing still is and will be a very important piece on monetization. Because most of the times, the constraints they see on mobile operator billing are payouts. The time the operator takes to pay. The chargebacks, the times of approvals, and what we say is, don't worry, we are here to help you and on solving all those issues. And so, in fact, we try to help on the payouts, and we try to provide the best payouts that are available in the region, or the best. Then, in terms of payments, we can also solve the issue by advancing sometimes, depending on the project, sometimes we advance the money to the content provider before receiving from the operator. Connecting to the operators and the chargebacks, we are there to manage them. So we want a hassle-free experience for a content provider or an aggregator that wants to use our services. We say, focus on your core business. Is your core business gaming? Is your core business what? Doing aggregation? Forget about the rest because we'll take care of it. In fact, you're talking about the slide I presented regarding the percentage of turnover split by payment method. And it was, it's for one customer we have, and I thought it would be a good example to explain why such a diversity of payment methods is important. Because, as you remember, we have credit card, boleto bancário, bank transfer, and mobile operator billing. And in fact, the user experience in terms of payments would split evenly around these methods. And this is curious to see that the user will make always the best choice for him. The huge difference there is that when you look at mobile operator billing, the average transaction value is very high. It's very low. It's around 4 reals. But the number of users is pretty huge. When you go to the other payment options, it's the other way around. The average transaction value is very high, 10 times more, but also 10 times less users. And so this will allow you to do a kind of a long tail strategy, thinking about how will I bring on board some users that do not have credit cards, and how will I convert them to higher ARPU payment options? It came to my mind that thing of the multinationals companies that is think global, act local. And I think that is very important. Because sometimes I see companies going to a given country and doing things as they were doing in their home country. That's not the way. Because especially in gaming, example, if you go to China with a game that is from Europe, it will not work. You'll need to do more, you need to cartoonize it, you need to put the local language. It's the same if you go from Europe to Brazil. You need to create something that is interesting for the local player. Of course, there are games that are universal. I mean, I'm thinking about the Pac-Man or something like that. Those are universal gamings. But the ones that have a history, that have a kind of iconography, that rely on language, you need to go and look for what each country is doing. On top of this, where we help you a lot, where we help our customers a lot, is through the regulatory issues and how must the payment options comply to what is being done in the region and what operators want you to do and what the flows that must be in place. Okay, that's why it's very important to have someone local that can help you on building a local strategy. It's quite kind of interesting because I was discussing here with my colleague that the context we've been having here, at least for people wanting to go to Latin America, to Middle East, to Africa, it's quite amazing. I think it's going to be a successful event for us, especially not only of knowing people, but in terms of business. Okay.
Thanks very much.
Thank you very much.